Welcome everyone. In the next module of the syllabus Engineering Mathematics 1, the next module is hyperbolic functions and logarithms of the complex number. But before we discuss the hyperbolic functions, firstly we are going to see the circular functions of complex number. In complex number, we have seen the Euler's formula, e raised to I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. And e raised to minus I theta as cos theta minus I sin theta. Okay. Now if I go on adding them, then we get e raised to I theta plus e raised to minus I theta is equal to 2 times cos theta if we add these two equations. But that is cos theta is equal to e raised to I theta plus e raised to minus I theta upon 2. If we go for a subtraction, then we get e raised to I theta minus e raised to minus I theta upon 2i as a value of a sine theta. Okay. Now, these forms are known as a Euler's exponential forms of the circular functions. Now, if we take a complex number, z is equal to x plus iy, then cos z will be given as cos z is equal to e raised to iz plus e raised to minus iz upon 2, and sin z is equal to e raised to iz minus e raised to minus iz upon 2i. So you remember these two relations. One is a Euler relation and second is a circular functions of the complex number. Okay. Now, with the help of these two, we are going to prove some circular functions identity. In case of the circular functions, we have one well-known identity, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. We can prove this by using the first formula of the circular functions, that is representation of a circular function in terms of the Euler's formula. For that, I am going to consider one LHS. LHS is equal to sin square theta plus cos square theta, but here sin theta is e raised to I theta minus e raised to minus I theta divided by 2i bracket square, plus cos square theta will be e raised to I theta plus e raised to minus I theta upon 2 bracket square. Okay. So this is nothing but, so in the first bracket a minus b bracket square, in the second a plus b bracket square. 1 upon 2i square is minus 1 by 4. So minus 1 by 4 into bracket. A square, that is e raised to I times 2 theta minus 2ab, that is e raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta plus e raised to minus I times 2 theta. Okay. This is for the first term, plus for the second term a plus b bracket square. Again 1 by 4 will be outside because 1 by 2 is there and its square is 1 by 4. A square, that is e raised to I times 2 theta plus 2 times e raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta plus e raised to minus I times 2 theta. So this is a plus b bracket square and a minus b bracket square expansions. Now from both we can have 1 by 4 common inside of the bracket. The minus sign is given inside of the bracket. We get minus e raised to I 2 theta plus 2 times e raised to I theta, e raised to minus I theta becomes a 0. That is e raised to 0. E raised to 0 is always 1. Hence we get 2 here. The minus plus becomes minus 2 times. Sorry, not 2. It is e raised to minus I times 2 theta plus e raised to I times 2 theta plus e raised to I theta, e raised to minus I theta gives me e raised to 0. Hence we have plus 2 here. Plus e raised to minus I times 2 theta. This is minus, this is plus, this is minus, this is plus, get cancelled. 2 plus 2 becomes 4. Hence 1 by 4 into 4 gives us 1. Okay. So this is for sin square theta plus cos square theta. Now we are going to see few more identities and some simple examples based on the circular functions of a complex number. So for that we are going to take one more identity, but this is represented where z is equal to x plus iy is a complex quantity. So 1 plus cos 2z, z is equal to x plus iy, which is a complex number. 1 plus cos 2z is 2 cos square z. This we have to prove. 1 plus cos 2z is 2 cos square z. So we begin with the LHS. LHS is equal to 1 plus cos 2z. Now because of the previous, as discussed previously, because of the identities, just a minute, I show you the same page once again. See, what is cos z? Cos z is e raised to iz plus e raised to minus iz upon 2. Therefore, cos 2z will be 1 plus e raised to I times 2z plus e raised to minus I times 2z upon 2. Is it okay? Now, what do we do? We cross multiply with this. Therefore, we get 2 plus e raised to I times 2z plus e raised to minus I times 2z whole divided by 2. But this 2 can be written as 2 into 1. And 1 can be written as e raised to 0, and this e raised to 0 can be written as e raised to iz minus, e raised to minus I times 2z minus e raised to I times 2z, that is e raised to I 2z into e raised to minus I 2z, like as a previous example. What is in the previous example? E raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta. See, e raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta. What happens with this? This is e raised to I theta minus I theta, which gives me e raised to 0, and anything raised to 0 is 1. So now we are going in the reverse direction. So while going in the reverse direction, what happens? This 2 can be written as 2 times e raised to iz into e raised to minus I, not z, it is 2z. E raised to I times 2z minus e raised to I times 2z. Plus e raised to I times 2z plus e raised to minus I times 2z. So this is equals to, and whole divided by 2 as it is. This is nothing but e raised to iz square plus 2 times e raised to I times 2z. Sorry, not 2z, here it is only z is expected. Sorry for that. Only z is expected. Okay, not 2z. E raised to iz into e raised to minus iz plus e raised to minus iz square. So this is a square plus 2ab plus b square, and whole divided by 2. And this is e raised to iz plus e raised to minus iz. Now look at there. There is a 2 in the denominator. I'm just taking the square of the numerator term, but same square, we can adjust the square of the denominator term. The square of the denominator is 4. Therefore, we multiply and divide by 2 to this. Hence, we get 4 in the denominator part. So, 4 is nothing but 2 square, and this 2 as it is. Okay. So, hence this is nothing but 2 times cos z, cos square z. So, hence 1 plus cos 2z is 1 plus cos 2z is 2 cos square z. This is how one can prove. Now, one more example we are going to see. Based on the circular functions, prove that 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta, 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta divided by 1 minus cos theta plus I sin theta is equal to cot theta by 2 into e raised to I times theta minus pi by 2. This we have to prove. Okay, we will begin with the left hand side. So LHS is equal to 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta, and the denominator is 1 minus cos theta plus I sin theta. Now we have to reach up to this. Cot theta by 2 means what? Cos theta by 2 upon sin theta by 2. So we have to adjust a term, cos theta by 2 upon sin theta by 2. Okay. Now how to work out this value? Basically, I required here theta by 2, and here the theta is comes. Ultimately, we remember some trigonometric identities which proves the relation between angle and half of the angle. See, we know the one clear relation, sin 2 theta is equal to 2 sin theta cos theta. Now here I am having only theta. So what is sin theta? Sin theta is equal to 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. Okay. Similarly, 1 plus cos theta. See, in the above example, 1 plus cos 2z. If I call 2z as a theta, then we have 1 plus cos theta. 2z as a theta. Therefore, we get 1 plus cos theta. 1 plus cos theta is equal to what? 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square z. If 2z is equal to theta, then z is equal to what? Theta by 2. Therefore, 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. So, keeping this in the mind, we replace this term 1 plus cos theta as 2 cos square theta by 2 plus I times sin theta is replaced by 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. See, I have reduced the angle theta in terms of the half of the angle, that is theta by 2. Now, what about denominator part? In the denominator part also, 1 minus cos theta is now replaced by 2 sin square theta by 2. I hope now you are getting a clear idea why 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. Okay. Now I am proceed further. Sin theta is again replaced by 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. Okay. Now, from numerator, one can have cos theta by 2 as a common, 2 also as a common. From denominator, 2 sin theta by 2 as a common. Hence, 2 cos theta by 2 into bracket cos theta by 2 plus I sin theta by 2. From the denominator, we are taking 2 times sin theta by 2 as a common. Therefore, inside of the bracket, sin theta by 2 plus I times this term is going out. So we get cos theta by 2. Okay. So 2, 2 get cancelled. Cos theta by 2, sin theta by 2 gives us cot theta by 2. Okay, now see, just from the right hand side we are getting the first term. Now we are thinking for the second term. What is this second term exactly? E raised to I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. So E raised to I times theta minus pi by 2 is cos theta minus pi by 2 plus I sin theta minus pi by 2. What adjustment is expected in this? Yes. Any guesses? Yes. Have a look in the denominator. Basically, to write the exponential term instead of this, we require cos plus I sin. Here it is sin plus I cos. Can I reverse this? Instead of sin, can I write a cos? Yes. How we can write it? Cos, we know that sin A is equal to cos 90 minus A. Sin A is equal to cos 90 minus A, or in your terms, sin theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta. Similarly, sin theta by 2 is equal to cos 90 minus theta by 2. Also, cos theta by 2 is equal to sin 90 minus theta by 2. Is it? So, this is equal to cos theta by 2 plus I sin theta by 2 whole divided by, instead of sin theta by 2, we write cos pi by 2 minus theta by 2 plus I sin pi by 2 minus theta by 2. Okay. Now, hence this is equals to, the numerator can be written as e raised to I times theta by 2. And the denominator part will be written as e raised to I times pi by 2 minus theta by 2. Now we take this denominator to the numerator, we get, sorry, this is not cos, this is a cot. Cot theta by 2 e raised to I theta by 2 into, as this denominator term going in the numerator, the sign of power becomes negative, minus I times pi by 2 minus theta by 2. As the base is same, we add the powers. Therefore, we have cot theta by 2 into e raised to I times, the I is common. Here we have the theta by 2. The minus sign given inside, we get minus pi by 2. Minus and minus become plus theta by 2. So theta by 2 plus theta by 2 becomes? Yes. It becomes theta. Theta minus pi by 2. So which is your expected? LHS is equal to RHS. Hence, the proof is over. I hope you have liked these examples. Already you have done similar kind of examples in your earlier chapters, that is trigonometric functions, which you have studied in the 11th and 12th standard. These are just preliminary part of that. In the next lecture, we are going to see what is meant by hyperbolic functions, what is the relation between circular function and the hyperbolic, and then some advanced level concept based on the hyperbolic functions. Thank you.